Madison? You and Marlo have been married for a year now. Currently, a month has passed since we moved in together. Isn't it time you started learning how to prepare normal food? I give you tips on how to cook properly every time and you mess it up again and again. Especially this morning's breakfast. I told you to make pancakes and what did you do? Lasagna! Who on earth cooks lasagna for breakfast? I could probably forgive it if it was at least tasty. But what you've cooked is terrible and I can't wash it down with a third glass of water.
Indy, please refrain from bombarding my phone with complaints in the middle of the day like this. I'd really appreciate it. I'm busy at my job. Let's talk later.
Well, because you never reply to my morning messages, I decided to contact you around midday instead. Always at this hour you respond. Don't look for excuses. You have to answer immediately when I write to you.
I'd love to talk to you about it when I get home. Not now!
In any case, you need to improve your cooking skills. You've never produced anything that tastes good. I think even a person who has never held a pot in his hands can cook better than you.
Why do you always eat all the food I cook, then?
What am I supposed to do, then? I don't want to starve to death.
I apologize, but I'm quite busy today.
Huh? You're running away from an important conversation again? We must discuss this immediately.
I have tasks to accomplish while I'm at work. That should be very apparent, right? I absolutely must return before things become worse.
Hey, heed my advice. I have much to say to you. This is quite significant. Inform your employer about your family emergency. We should discuss this now. If you can't cook, how are you going to raise future kids? I'd want to discuss this since I'm worried about my son's future. Madison?
Indy! Were you the one who threw my pasta in the garbage can?
I think it might have been me. Is there an issue?
Huh? There is indeed. I knew I'd get home too late to cook supper today. I prepped it from yesterday night. Why would you do this?
I suppose you're now at home. You took much too long. Food that is prepared the night before will always taste awful. I merely threw it out beforehand to spare you the hassle. It could already be corrupt. We could have all gotten food sickness from it. That's very dangerous. I had to discard it.
To begin with, it was in the fridge. It wouldn't even spoil that quickly, considering that it isn't even the summer. Additionally, you shouldn't waste so much food to begin with. Nobody is forcing you to consume my food if you don't want to. How could you discard the whole thing? You certainly shouldn't have done that. What will we be eating tonight?
We don't have any food in our home because of you. Nothing you produce is remotely appetizing. Tonight, my friends and I are going to a restaurant. Even attempting to stomach your awful meals won't be anything I have to worry about.
Huh? I'm to blame? That spaghetti took me hours to make last night, only for you to toss it all away! And now you're going out to eat?
I want to avoid getting ill from eating your meals. I'm thus going to a classy Chinese restaurant. Be sure to have something ready for tomorrow. Because of you, everyone in this home will starve to death.
Marlo, what are you doing now? Can we talk?
Yes, I've called the cab and I'm headed home. It will take about 15 minutes. We're eating the pasta you made last night tonight, right? I adore your cuisine, especially your spaghetti with Parmesan. I'm really excited. Anyway, what's going on? Everything all right?
Well, if your mother hadn't thrown it away, we may have been eating it.
Wait, what?
I saw that everything had been disposed of in a garbage container when I got back home. She made no attempt to conceal it, so it was clearly done just for my annoyance. When I returned home, she wasn't there. She proudly informed me that she was the one who tossed it away when I contacted her and inquired about it.
What's the deal? Why did she act in that manner? My mother never wasted food.
Since I cooked it yesterday night, she said it's bad. She tossed it away because of this. Can you imagine that?
No way! Are you for real?
I'm not joking. I'm sorry, but by the time you come home, I won't be able to make anything.
Don't worry about it. Everything is okay. You are not at blame. I apologize for my mom. I never knew she could behave so horribly.
I'm not sure why she despises me so much. I've just been courteous and kind to her. She has been picking on me mercilessly for the last month.
She undoubtedly still feels bad about splitting from my dad. After the divorce, I was okay with her moving in with us, but it turns out it wasn't such a great idea after all. Madison, I really apologize. I'm not sure what to say at all. I would never have agreed to live with her if I had known how she would treat you.
Put no responsibility on yourself. Since we would be saving money by going back with Mom, I felt it was an excellent plan. Additionally, I had mixed feelings about her having to live alone in such a large home. Furthermore, you don't need to apologize. But I do appreciate it. Simply put, I have no idea what I'll prepare for supper today.
How about we go out to get something to eat?
Are you certain? I'm aware that you probably feel worn out from work and would want to relax at home.
I'm good. It would be great to go on a little date.
Yes, it's an excellent idea.
Let's meet right away at a restaurant. Maybe something Chinese?
Definitely not. Let's go to that little Italian one. La Dolce Vita, if I'm not mistaken.
Got it. Really great place, by the way. We haven't been there for a long time. Can you get there in an hour?
Yeah, that's fine. See you.
Hey, Madison. I know you said you would be going back to your parents' house today, but how could you leave so early? Don't you think that because you're going first thing in the morning, you ought to have prepared my breakfast? The fridge is almost completely empty. You shouldn't even be leaving the home alone on a weekend like this. Don't you have any errands to do around here? If you have time to spend and play about, you need to be practicing your culinary talents at home. Do you even know what you're doing? Madison, why don't you answer? How rude of you to not listen to me when I speak to you. We're gonna have a serious talk when you get back. You little girl are really disrespectful. I'll keep going until you really apologize to me. You'd better be ready. Madison, why still not at home? What is happening? Why would a wife stay out so late? How will Marlo react? Have you given it any thought? What do you have to say? Will you think about being decent in some way? Where are you at this moment? You obviously can manage to travel home on your own, so I'll pick you up. What are you going to cook today? Additionally, it's not only cooking. The clothes and dishes have been accumulating because you were absent the whole day. Immediately return home, or let me know where you are so I can come fetch you. Madison! Do you truly want to skip home tonight as well? This is plenty for me! Why are you acting this way? I wish I didn't have to do this, but it seems that Marlo and I need to discuss about obtaining a divorce from you. You impose no options on me. This time you've really pulled it off. I trust you're prepared. Madison! Marlo and you are divorcing each other. Enough is enough. Marlo and I haven't spoken about it yet, but I'm certain that once I tell him what you've done, he'll concur with me. You've truly built your own grave.
Huh?
Wow, you're responding to me now? Will you return to your home?
I'm going to come back today.
You no longer have a place in this house, which I'm sure you are aware of. You must be ready for the divorce. Madison! When you return after being away for 3 days straight, you've already left again? And you stated you were having supper somewhere else?
Is it a problem?
Absolutely! Where is my dinner? I anticipate you to make up for the time you've been away as my daughter-in-law, including preparing my food, of course. You must prepare my meal straight now and return home. Don't forget about the accumulated duties. Going out to dine is not something you have time for.
What? I won't prepare your meal. It's a waste of both time and food. Isn't it true that all you want to do is use my cooking as an excuse to treat me badly? You threw away my spaghetti, and I still don't feel sorry for you. Why would I prepare meals for someone who would only discard it?
To avoid having to throw your food out. That is why I'm advising you to practice and learn how to cook. Making poor cuisine means squandering the stuff on you.
So you didn't cook even once during the 3 days I wasn't present? Is that accurate?
Cooking for the family is the wife's job.
Therefore, despite the fact that there are veggies in the freezer that you could have prepared yourself, you essentially starved yourself?
My poor son shouldn't have married someone like you. How humiliating is that? I am eagerly anticipating his divorcing you.
It's Marlo, Mom.
Marlo, you must pay attention to this. It concerns Madison. She left no food for me while she was gone for 3 whole days.
Yes, she did say that she wouldn't cook for you anymore.
You heard, huh? That is absurd, isn't it? She said that to me? I find it unbelievable.
Right now I'm with her. She filled me in on every detail the previous week.
Huh? You're with her right now? Where are you? Did you go to a restaurant or something?
No, we're not at a restaurant. I'm having dinner with my wife's family.
What? How come you're eating there?
For the last 3 days, I've been eating the meals that Madison and her mother prepared together.
What on earth do you think you're doing, exactly? She made you eat such horrible food. I can't believe that. My Marlo, my poor boy. Are you feeling sick? You should call a doctor as soon as you can. I don't want you to get food poisoning.
Disgusting food? We know you've been spoiling Madison's food on purpose.
What? What does that mean?
You were never aware that we were observing you, even though we continued doing so. Did you really not realize this whole time?
Realize what?
Remember all the times you screamed at the top of your lungs for me to try the casserole my wife made, and as it turned out, it was terrible? The thing is, I've eaten this casserole before, and it was absolutely normal and delicious. I didn't say anything to you, but since then I've been following you. I know every time you spoil the food my wife cooked.
Wait, that's not true.
I never thought you would stoop to such a thing.
Wait now.
And for your information, Madison has repeatedly won local cooking competitions in our city. She's a great cook.
I don't believe it.
The fact that you threw away her food just because you didn't like her will never change.
Wait, Marlo.
That probably implies we won't be living with you any longer. We just closed on a new apartment, and we've already begun talking about it. Also, I will no longer send you money, as I did every month.
What the heck? We've only been living together for 2 months. You cannot just go. How about I... And what do you mean you're not going to send me money? What am I going to live on?
You want me to remain silent while my own wife is being tortured, do you? I'm unable to carry out such action. We are unable to continue with you.
I'm done. I apologize. I'll stop acting that way going forward. I also won't be a fraud. I'll treat her well.
What you say doesn't matter to me. We can no longer coexist with you. We've already organized our departure. We already have the lease for our new flat, as I previously said. The cause of Madison's absence from cooking for you the previous 3 days? She wanted you to understand how fortunate you were to have a daily home-cooked lunch served to you. However, you tormented her for the whole 3 days without even pausing to consider everything that she had done for you. Never once did you consider thanking her for everything. I apologize, but we are unable to continue. We are unable to remain with you.
Hey, Marlo! She has my gratitude. I only want to impart better behavior to her. I wished her every success.
Anyway, I want you to think deeply about what you've done now that you're on your own. I hope you comprehend how awful you have been to Madison.
Marlo, wait!
Only now I am beginning to realize that my mother did such vile things only because her husband left us. She started behaving strangely since then. I tried to support her, but the way she treated my wife could not stay like that. At the time, I thought I was doing the best thing when I left her at home alone and moved to an apartment with my wife. But what I'm getting at is that she passed away 2 days after that. I still think that the blame for this lies with me. I left her at a difficult time. Her heart could not bear loneliness and depression. My point that you should be closer to your family, even when you don't understand them. Maybe something happened to them or they just need to be alone for a while. Do not forget to hear and be heard. This is very important so that it is not too late. You were pretty weird, but I still miss you, Mom.